can you solve this geometry challenge? Here's the question. Let's begin with a rectangle. Now let's draw two segments like this. So we created three triangles like this, and the area of this yellow triangle is given as 6 square units, the area of this orange triangle is 4 square units, and the area of this blue right triangle is equivalent to 19 square units. Now the question is, what is the rectangle's area? Now pause this video right now and see if you can answer this question, because I will show you the solution in 3, 2, 1. And of course, before I will show you the solution, I will begin with the answer. So the answer to this question is 70 square units. And in this video, I will provide two different methods to answer this question. The first one is by using similar triangles. And the second one, I will show you one solution. This is shortcut, but in this shortcut, there's a lot of concept inside of it. And this is the ratio of areas. Alright, so let's begin with the similar triangles. I will show you how I get 70 square units. Now, before we begin to our solution, of course, let's name some important points like this. From here, what we're going to do is to use what we call the vertical angles, because vertical angles are congruent. So these two angles right over here, we can call this as alpha because they are equal, they're congruent. And these two vertical angles, we can call this as beta. Now let's focus on this right triangle GAF, because what we're going to do is to put this right triangle on the other side like this. And let's call this vertex as A prime. Originally, this is vertex A. So this is now A prime. Now from here, we can say, using AAA similarity, that triangle ABC is similar to triangle A prime EC. And since they are similar, we can say that the ratio of their areas is equal to the ratio of their corresponding sides raised to the power of 2. So we have 4 over 6 plus 19 equals AC over C A prime raised to the power of 2. Now simplify this. We have 4 over 25 and get the square root on both sides. Since AC over C A prime are side length, we don't care to the negative values of this ratio. So this is just 2 over 5 equals AC over C A prime. So we can say that AC over CA prime can be written as 2x over 5x. So this AC, we can say this is 2x, and this CA prime is 5x. And take note, from A to A prime, this is just the length of our square FE or GD. Therefore, we can say that AA prime is congruent or equal to side FE. In short, we can say that this FE, we can rewrite this as 2x plus 5x, or simply 7x. Now, going back to our figure, since we have DEFG, so GD is parallel to FE, therefore, these two triangles, triangle ABC, is similar to triangle FBE. And knowing this, what we're going to do is to let the white region as Y, and we can use again the ratio of areas. So 4 over 4 plus y, the ratio of the areas of these two similar triangles, is equal to the ratio of their corresponding sides raised to the power of 2, or simply 2x over 7x raised to the power of 2. Now simplify, x over x is just 1, of course, and 2 over 7 raised to the power of 2, this will give us 4 over 49. Since the numerator are the same, so we can say that 4 plus y equals 49. Subtract 4 on both sides, so y equals 45. Therefore, the value of this y, or the area of this white region, is simply equal to 45 square units. Now, the goal is the rectangle's area, so just add 6, 45, and 19, and sure enough, we get 70 square units. Therefore, using our first method, we can say that the area of this rectangle is 70 square units. Now let's begin with our second solution. So let's have this figure again. And to use the ratio of areas, what we're going to do is to connect this vertex F and C like this. Now let's call this area B equal to X. Why not? And now, we will use the concept of this triangle or the area of the triangle, because the area of a triangle is equal to half the area of a rectangle that can be drawn with the same base and height. Therefore, from here, we can say that the area of triangle FCE is equal to half the area of our rectangle DEFG. In short, we can rewrite the area of triangle FCE as 6 plus x plus 19, or simply half the area of this rectangle. And x plus 6 plus 19 simplifies to x plus 25. So this triangle FCE is simply equal to x plus 25. Now from here, take note that triangle ABC is similar to triangle FBE. In short, we can say that the ratio of AB to AF equals the ratio of BC to CE. Now, we will use the concept of the ratio of areas, and we will focus at the second part. We have two triangles with the same height, because given this figure, we can say that the ratio of their areas must be equal to the ratio of their bases. Now, we will use this concept to answer our question. Now, focus on this triangle BCA and the triangle ACF. Now, these two triangles have the same height for sure. Therefore, the ratio of their bases is equal to the ratio of their area. So, this AB, we can say that this is 4, and AF, this is X. We will do the same thing to this triangle BFE. Now, triangle BCF and triangle CFE have the same height. Therefore, the ratio of their areas is equal to the ratio of their bases. So we can say that BC is just X plus 4 and CE is X plus 25. So we have an equation for over X equals X plus 4 over X plus 25. Now cross multiply, we get 4X plus 100 equals X squared plus 4X. Subtracting 4X on both sides, this is just 0. And get the square root on both sides, we get X equals 10. So this X, simply 10 square units. Now, add 10 and 25, we get 35. And 10 plus 35 is simply equal to 45. Square unit. So the white region again is 45 square units, and the rectangle's area simply the sum of 6, 45, and 19, which is 70 square units. Therefore, given these two different methods, similar triangles and ratio of areas, we arrive at the same result, as the area of this rectangle is 70 square units. And as always, we are done.